Dave Morales takes you backstage with Altered Carbon stars Anthony Mackie, Renee Elise Goldsberry, and more on BackstageOL.com. Don't forget to click the subscribe button below for more backstage interviews from across the globe. This is Backstage with Altered Carbon.
Here we are again, my friend.
Yeah, man, good to see you.
Dude, a lot of people looking forward to the show, including myself. How excited are you now that it's finally going to be out there?
I'm very excited. It was a long time coming. It's been a year, almost a year and a half now since we started this process. And I'm happy to see, finally, people get to see me kick people in the face.
I love that, man. You know, and let's talk about that, because besides that, what makes this, like, it's such a different role for you? You nailed this, by the way.
Thank you.
And, I mean, but it is, it's different. And I think as actors, you try to challenge yourself with each role.
Right.
So my question to you is, what makes this so different than anything else you've done?
Well, with this is a love story. And I think the vulnerability of the character, most people haven't seen me do. Renee has a very cunning ability to make me emotional. Just because she's a phenomenal actress, an amazing woman, and a sweet person. So it's we worked really well together, and our energies kind of cohesively came together in a beautiful way.
Let's talk about the sets, because you have worked on some incredible sets, this one included. I think this one just, I love the sci-fi genre as a whole,
yeah.
But when you look at this, I think of the sets and the look of the show as another character. As you looked around, you're filming, what does it look like? Well, how do you feel when you see?
I was literally blown away. There's not a lot, I mean, there's a lot of CGI, because we had to create
right.
a completely different planet, but a lot of the stuff were practical sets, you know, and being able to walk through and actually experience it and see it and touch it makes your performance 100 times better than having to make believe that it's there. You know, coming from the Marvel universe, a lot of that stuff is, you know, it's a blue screen and you have to say, oh, it's a monster, he's coming, duck, you know. But with this, it's exciting when you walk on set and you marvel at the talent of the people who are around you, for their ability to be able to put these sets together and build this world it really was a coup for all of us to be able to experience it in the actual factual.
Are you a binge watch kind of guy?
You know, it depends on how good the show is. Like, there's certain shows like Ozark. Mm-hmm. When I watched the first season of Ozark, I literally just kept going. Like right now, Netflix has this show called Who Killed Malcolm X? And I watched the first 10 minutes and the rest of my day was over. I couldn't turn it off, you know? And that's what I love about this show. Every time an episode ends, you gotta go to that next. When I first got the cut of all 8 of these episodes, my day was done, you know?
So my follow-up to that, we'll close with this. People are going to stay up. I start negotiating with myself. I'm like, one more episode, I'll get 6 hours of sleep.
Right.
Okay, one more, I'll get 5 hours. People are going to watch this. They may miss work. They may miss school the next day. What's your excuse? What is Anthony Mackie saying the good excuse is like for missing?
Please don't miss work or school.
I'm trying to give him an out,
just
man.
Just start early. How about that? Get up, start early. Watch it on a weekend, all right? Start Saturday morning, make you a nice little fruit plate or something. Hit the couch with a nice glass of wine and enjoy the experience. So you'll be done by like 6 p.m. and you can go to bed.
We're all excited as fans. I can only imagine y'all just ready to put this out in the world. What was it, a big thrill to be a part of this? And
it was. For me, I was joining the show already. You know, they had such a successful first season, and Renee did such a phenomenal job that, you know, coming in, I was excited to join this group of people who were telling this amazing story. And it was exciting to have a jumping off point that we didn't necessarily feel tied to mm-hmm. in the second season. And so for me to be able to be trapped, to be the first person to do this character,
create this
and
role.
it was a wonderful experience. A little nerve-wracking, you know, because fans are fans,
especially sci-fi fans.
Oh.
Like, even like anything, you know, like comic related, but sci-fi in that genre, kind of people, they're hardcore.
That I do know, having portrayed a comic book character Misty Knight on Marvel's Luke Cage.
I know
how they are. So
yeah.
It's exciting.
For me, I felt, you know, it felt a little bit like coming back your sophomore year in high school. Oh. So you should have some kind of, you know, hey, I know this place, but everybody's different. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Literally everybody was new and was different. So that was kind of a surreal experience. But I was so excited to have these people, like they were a gift because they're the reason there is a season two. Yeah. The fact that you were there and Anthony was there and all, you know, Leela and, you know, just it's an amazing, I think Chris Connor and I were really grateful that we, you know, got some real pinch hitters to come in season two.
Anthony Mackie singing your praises. He's going on about it, but it's co-stars and the magic of the show. So I asked him a question. I'm going to ask you both the same question. Are you binge watchers? Because you know we're going to binge this.
Yes.
I am a binge watcher.
Absolutely. Well, they set it up like that.
Right. That little thing where it says skip to the next episode, you have to say yes.
I start negotiating sleep at that point.
Like, well, like, okay, how much do I really need?
I do that all the time.
It's hard to turn it off, and especially if it's good. And like, you know, it's this one's hard to turn off, and I'm really proud of that.
Can we talk costumes too?
Yes.
What do you want to know? Fun.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
So, our amazing costume designer. Just from the ground up. Mm-hmm. And she's won awards.
Yes, like, many.
For many different shows.
Yeah.
And so when I came in, felt completely safe. And she's like, you know, I want her to have this jacket that like protects her sleeve because she had these renderings and the fittings and where she was sourcing this stuff from. And then the way that they dyed it and painted it. And it was beautiful. I felt so thought of, so taken care of, and then yours.
Well, I was just glad. I just wanted to look good.
She's like, I'm not out in the forest.
There's two things I want, right? I got to do a lot of fighting, and I want to feel like I can do. I mean, I'm not going to be wearing anything that I couldn't fight in. I want to be super comfortable, and you know, and be able to kind of be this. I want to feel powerful.
Yeah.
And I feel powerful when I look good. Man. I can't help it.
That's all you
and
need.
So she did it.
Welcome to Altered Carbon.
Thank you
so much.
Season two. Exciting? Yeah.
Super exciting.
Did you guys, how familiar were you with season one? And then when you found out you were a part of this, were you kind of like, I think that'd be surreal?
Yeah, I had just only sort of found out as part of the talks, and I watched it, and I really fell in love with the themes and the philosophies underneath. And then I was super excited because I'd never played in sci-fi before. So the technical, like technical part of the acting is a huge challenge and super fun, and I had a blast.
I remember when I was in LA for pilot season. I do live in Berlin in Germany, and I went there for 2 months. And every time I went to my boxing gym, I was looking at these gigantic billboards that Joel Kinnaman in this plastic bag in it, and I was so captured and mesmerized by it. I thought, like, what is that? So I started watching this show and I started binging it, and I saw it all in one go. I was like in this crazy fever dream of it. And then as soon as I had the chance to put myself on tape for it, an audition, I thought, like, wow, that might be my shot to be part of one of my favorite shows. And then when my manager told me that I got the offer, I just couldn't believe it. It was jaw-dropping. It was like somebody told you get to play with all the friends you made while you watch television. And it was a dream come true, ultimately.
I think it would be surreal because this show, what I love about it are the sets. Now, just watching it on TV. Now, filming it, I've been on sets before.
Yeah.
And people are like, ah, it's just a set. But these seem to me like they would be just inspiring, like just awe-inspiring in the sense that colorful, bright character of themselves. Am I right?
Yeah, our design team does an amazing job. And what's so cool is so much of it's like styrofoam or like these other interesting elements that look super realistic. And then when you get really close, you're also impressed by the creativity and the ingenuity of it.
Yeah.
And then some of the locations they would mimic on stage, and the sort of the ability to mimic it so astutely was, the talent pool is bananas.
Carrie Meyer, the production designer, is a wizard. He is amazing. The world that he has come up with is so dense and so rich, and it plays so much into your acting. I remember when I told a couple of actor friends of mine that I was going to be on the show, they said, like, enjoy your green screen time. I remember being in front of a green screen for like 1.5 times during 6 months. It's incredible. They built it all, and it's you never had to play make believe with like a tennis ball on a stick or anything. You know, everything was tangible all the time. So that was one of the perks of being in this great world that is portrayed in Altered Carbon 2.
I have to ask you this question: how fun is it to be the bad guy?
Oh, on a scale from 1 to 10?
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere upward from 12. But I wouldn't say that he's a baddie only. You know, you will come to see that there is something that is very moving and touching and very, very, very personal about his conflicts. And other than that, you're going to enjoy a lot of crazy, badass banter with this.
I know.
Great lady here.
I cleared that question with the publicity department.
Yeah.
I said, can I ask that? No spoilers. I can absolutely ask him that. It's great to meet you both. Highly anticipated season 2.
Yes.
You excited?
Beyond excited. It's been 2 years in the coming, so we're ready.
Were people asking you guys, this is that, you know, there's like a group of people that are just addicted to the show, I and me included, that are like sci-fi nerds. Like I dissect everything, you know, about the show and things that, you know, are changes or things that are, you know, coming up in the show. But did people ask you, like, when you got the scripts, is my question,
mm-hmm.
were people like, what's going to happen? What's going to happen?
Constantly, even from my agents, they were just wondering if I made it past the season 1. So it's
they're like, do you have a job?
Yes, exactly. But the gift of having a new character in the show and being surprised by those scripts when they showed up and having Dig there is amazing.
What's so captivating about this story?
Well, I just want to say I watched season 1 before I even auditioned for this show, and Chris was my favorite character. Yeah. And so when I got the offer to play this part, I was so excited to work with him because I think he is extraordinary.
Dear, thank
in
you.
This show, and it's a privilege to be a part of it.
Totally lying.
I'm lying. He paid me to say this.
No,
wow, it's going to be a long day.
Yeah.
It's going to be expensive for
it's
you.
It's going to be expensive.
I'm an early interview of the day, so it's gonna, no, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I'm just here to make money off Chris.
Thank you.
That came out wrong.
Yeah.
I take it back. But I mean, it's so exciting. I'm a huge fan of the show, and to be a part of it is just you know, the best feeling. And
not just a part of it. You are a true soul of the show now.
Thank you.
Yeah, I don't want to do any spoilers.
I'm really careful about what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But that's okay.
Yeah,
I'm not spoiling anything with that. But no, she's a wonderful presence in the show that
brings
the show back to a center that is awesome.
I completely agree with that. Thank you for sharing that story because I wanted to ask people that were new, you know, if they knew the first season, and like, oh, now I'm part of it.
Yeah.
That would just be surreal to really get into something and now, hey, now I'm a part of that.
Yeah, it is surreal. It's surreal to already love something and then get to be a part of it without, you know.
That's fun.
It's so fun.
Yeah.
Love that. You went to high school in Houston, Texas, you told me before I walked in the room.
I did. I went to the Kincaid School in Houston, Texas for 2 years and graduated from that and don't really remember much of it, but I miss Houston a lot.
We miss you, man.
Is there any better food in the United States than in Houston, Texas?
I was just talking to somebody upstairs about this. They're like, I've been to Houston a couple of times. And I'm like, oh, were we okay? Were we nice? Because, you know, worst drivers, not me, but the whole city. That's
worse than the worst drivers.
People just cut people up. It's like a racetrack in Houston. But and then the construction everywhere.
Yeah.
290 is still under construction. Probably started when you were there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was 3 when they started that, and they're still working on it. But the food... people come back to.
Amazing, yeah, and the Vietnamese food, it's brilliant. And actually, Houston is a great example of what our show, is city-wise and building, world-building-wise, is a perfect example of what a city could be in the future.
Melting pot.
Yes, it is so diverse, which is our show.
That's one of the best, I was thinking that last night when we were on the carpet and all standing together, I was like, look at, without ever...
I know.
It's amazing.
It's crazy.
Yeah, it's...
A beautiful thing of having such a diverse cast, and that's an example of what Houston is and why Houston is exciting and fun.